Yo, what up, what up? Welcome back to the channel where we mix fitness and music. So in this one, what I wanted to do is dive into something that was asked to me by Phil M, one of my subscribers. And what he asked was, if he's eating healthy, working out, why is he feeling hungry at the end of the day, so closer towards the night, all right? Now, this is something that a lot of people bring up to me. But the one thing that I must stress is that without knowing your actual goal, it's very hard to answer the question in itself. So let's determine, first we need to determine what your goal actually is, whether it be to lose weight, gain weight, or maintain your weight. And then you could decide if feeling hungry closer to the evening time before you go to bed is a good thing. So let's talk about what that is and what it actually means. So if you're feeling hungry, usually that's a sign in this, a sign that your body's metabolism is actually moving at a fast pace, right? Not necessarily saying really fast, but it's moving fast enough to where you're digesting your food. And usually you want to dip into a state of hunger somewhere around 3 to 4 hours throughout the day after eating any type of meal, all right? Usually with that being the case, you can be on board to gaining muscle, losing weight, whatever you actually feel needs to be done. If your body's getting hungry every 3 to 4 hours, that's usually the determining factor on if you're gonna get there. Because what'll actually happen is if you allow your body to eat every 3 to 4 hours, it gives you the chance and ability to bring in the necessary vitamins, minerals, protein, fat, and carbs throughout the day in different meals. So it can happen 3, 4, maybe 5 times throughout the day. So that is always gonna be a plus, because you're giving your body the ability to take in more of the necessary things to help you hit your goal. Now, if you're not feeling hungry, let's say I eat pizza for breakfast and I don't feel hungry for the rest of the day. Well, all throughout the day, whether I'm doing activities that involve high levels of activity or high levels of calories being burned, if that be the case, right, and I'm going throughout the day, I'm burning all these calories, but I notice I ate pizza for breakfast, and for the rest of the day I'm really not feeling hungry, even closer towards the night I'm not really feeling hungry, where there were areas where I could have possibly took in protein and carbs to help me get closer to my goal, I didn't have that ability because I ate too many calories, maybe for breakfast or lunch or dinner, and that puts me in a situation where I'm not hungry. So if you're trying to lose weight, Phil M, if you're trying to lose weight, feeling hungry closer towards the nighttime could actually be a good thing, depending on how you've structured your day and what you want out of it, okay? Maybe you have a workout first thing in the morning, so going to bed hungry may not be exactly how you want to feel. You might decide to have something very light, such as a protein shake, something as light as grilled chicken, which usually involves mainly protein, and you want to stay away from the carbohydrates as you get closer to the nighttime, all right? That'll put you in a position where you can actually eat and still maintain what you're trying to do as far as reaching your goals. Because if someone told me they're not comfortable with feeling hungry as they go closer towards bedtime and they want to consume something, the most I would tell them to go for is a protein shake or something involving very high protein and very low carbohydrate. But that's only if their goal is to lose weight. If you're trying to build muscle, for most of my clients, I'll tell them feel free to consume carbs and protein closer to the evening time, but you want to keep a balance, all right? The balance is going to be where you consume more protein, less carbohydrates, but you still consume carbs. So consume carbs, just consume less, and then you'll sprinkle in your fats here and there. But the goal and focus is that you don't go to sleep hungry, because you're going to find that if you sleep hungry, in order to build muscle, you're going to see that if there's some areas where the body goes through long periods of time without consuming any calories, those are the areas where you stand a chance of possibly putting your body in a position where you can't gain as much muscle. If you're willing to take the sacrifice, that's cool too. And you know, if you're willing to take that sacrifice, you can go to bed with a lower amount of calories, wake up and decide to replenish after you've already woken up. But you're gonna be a little backed up on the amount of calories, more like a deficit. And you're gonna have to replace all what's necessary, bring you up to speed. And then after that, the more calories that come in, those will be the calories that are geared towards the muscle being packed on. So if you don't wanna go through that process, which is, makes it a little more difficult, you would consume food all throughout the day. Usually it'll come in every 3 to 4 hours. If you notice that you're not hungry before going to bed, usually that's a case where you've consumed too many calories in the previous meal, all right? If you consume enough calories, the amount that you're supposed to, within 3 to 4 hours, you will be hungry. And as the time progresses, you'll get more and more hungry. If you dip into 6, 7, 8 hours and you're not hungry, there's an issue with the last meal you consumed. Maybe there was too many calories and you need to now cut back in order to structure your routine or your eating regimen where you only have your food coming in every 3 to 4 hours, not once in the morning and once at the end of the day. This is the structure you would look to do if you were going to build muscle. When it comes down to burning fat, you can structure your caloric intake differently. It can be done once in the morning, once at night, however you feel the need. As long as you stay within a deficit, you're guaranteed to lose weight. The biggest thing that I'm trying to touch on is what I think your question is if I'm going to bed hungry, what will that amount to? You know, is that a good thing? Is that something that I want to feel comfortable about? And that's my whole thing. You should only feel comfortable if your goal is geared towards. Cool. So hopefully, Phil, I answered your question. For the most part, when it all boils down to it, if you're feeling hungry closer towards going to bed and you're not comfortable with it, I would consume a protein shake or something involving high proteins. All right, usually it's grilled chicken, grilled fish, or something like that. And then you can actually sleep on something and really not affect your goals if your goal is to actually lose weight. If your goal is to gain weight or build muscle, then yes, you would definitely aim for some carbs, some protein, and some fats. You just moderate the amounts that actually come in. Usually it's gonna be based on whatever was consumed throughout the day. You wanna go ahead and fill in all your gaps at the end of the night, but be mindful of how many calories and carbs and protein and all that stuff comes in. Hopefully that answers your question. I'm gonna go ahead and finish it up right here. Y'all know what it is, conservative guy. I'm out.